finals have now become a riveting series, thanks to a record-setting performance by the Magic in Game 3. But the Lakers still have the best-of-seven set ahead, 2-1. With the pivotal Game 4 on tap tonight at a sold-out Amway Arena. And as we're ready to resume the series, we once again want to tell you about a remarkable 7-year-old. That's Gina Marie Incandela, who's been diagnosed with autism. A few years ago, Gina Marie didn't even speak. But with music therapy and plenty of love and support, she began talking and singing and singing. And she's now becoming the most popular anthem singer in the country. The Magic players, the organization, and now countless others have been inspired by this very special first grader. And tonight she returns to sing again for her beloved Magic. And with the proper formal introduction, let's go to PA announcer Paul Porter.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please rise, remove your caps during the singing of our national anthem, being performed tonight by 7-year-old Gina Marie Incandela.
Starting lineups. First for the Los Angeles Lakers, the Western Conference champion. And one forward, 6'8 from UCLA, number 3, Trevor Ariza. And the other forward, 7 foot from Spain, number 16, Pau Gasol. At center, 7 foot from St. Joseph High School, number 17, Andrew Bynum. At the one guard, 6'1 from Arkansas Little Rock, number 2, Derek Fisher. And at the other guard, 6'6 from Lower Merion High School, number 24, Kobe Bryant. The head coach of the Los Angeles Lakers is Phil Jackson.
Magic fans, it's playoff time. Lights.
Magic fans, it's your boy Scotty B. Welcome out to the Amway Arena for game number 4. We are live on ABC. Let's make some noise. Please welcome your community ambassador, Nick Anderson. Nick, what time is it?
You know what time it is? It's Magic time. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go Magic!
white ignite.
Boom! And now, Sam and Jim, your Eastern Conference champion, Orlando Magic! And on score, 6-10 from the Celtic High School, number 9, Rashard Hughes. And the other four, 6-10 from Turkey, number 15, Ito Galoo. And on guard, 6-5 from Western Kentucky, number 11, Courtney.
This 1 minute, a chance to march into the pantheon of greatness where a legacy of champions awaits.
Charged right back into these NBA finals with the best shooting performance in finals history. A blistering first half and a raucous crowd carried them to the game three victory as they pulled within 2-1. But despite all the euphoria here in Orlando and the crowd fired up again, it's still the Los Angeles Lakers who have the lead in this series. And Los Angeles has followed every one of their losses in this postseason with an impressive win. Will they take command of the series tonight, or can the Magic even things up? It's time to find out. And good evening, everyone, and welcome to game four of the 2009 NBA Finals. Along with Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand, Doris Burke will join us shortly. The resilient Magic, they did it again. They bounced back after a heart-wrenching loss, get themselves back in the series. And as we mentioned, Jeff, they did it with an unbelievable shooting performance against a team that had defended them well. The question is, how do they do it, and can they continue it?
Well, you can never count on shooting 62% again in a game. But what they can do is continue to play fast in transition, getting the ball into the paint first to start their drive and kick game. And if they pass on target like this possession and get LA in rotation, they can get good shots. The same with their pick and roll game. If they set solid screens, come off the score, they'll get shots like that. Rashard Lewis, critical jump shot late in game three. And you see the balance. Five guys scoring over 18 points. The question is, can they defend and rebound against this Laker juggernaut?
And a Laker team that is going to be desperate and hungry after the loss like they've done all throughout the playoffs. But in game three, Mark, Kobe Bryant and the Lakers, they couldn't close it out. Now, Kobe took responsibility, but he also said defense was the reason that they lost. We've seen throughout the postseason, when they play strong defense, they're almost unbeatable. That wasn't the case in game three.
Well, absolutely, Mike. This is a Magic team that's absolutely lethal on the offensive end. The Los Angeles Lakers cannot afford to take off halves, which is what they did. The Magic shot 75% from the field. They have to play defense like they did in the previous four games, holding teams under 100 points and playing phenomenal. Not last basketball game. Kobe Bryant says we must play at a higher level defensively. But on the offensive end, it's Pau Gasol. They have to involve him because he's too athletic, too big, and too skilled to just be a regular guy on the floor. On the offensive end, it's a recipe for disaster towards the Orlando Magic's defense anytime Gasol touches the basketball.
The Lakers still lead 2-1, but the crowd's ready, the Magic's ready. Can they even the series tonight? We'll find out after this timeout.
Are on the floor. There's your starting lineups presented by 99 from Rockaware. As we're set to go, a packed house once again at Amway Arena. They were so into the game. In game three, Magic players all giving him some credit as the whistle blows on the tip. Scott Foster asking Bennett Salvatore, was that a good toss? Salvatore says yes, so he says a violation against the Magic. If it wasn't a good toss, they'd do it again. Instead, it's Laker ball. Both teams started so hot from the field. Game one, we talked so much about Orlando's great shooting. Lakers also shot the ball so well early on. That's one of the reasons they actually led after the first quarter of game three. Kobe Bryant had that brilliant first, but slowed down afterwards. Ariza to the basket. Good hard drive. Too strong. Battle for the rebound. Turkoglu. And Jeff, you said rebounding will be critical for Orlando tonight.
And the problem is they've got a rebound off the double team. They double-teamed Kobe Bryant in the post. They had rotation, and he was still able to secure the ball.
Bryant with a hand in his face thrills his first jumper. Kobe Bryant saying yesterday he loved the challenge of the bounce-back game. He said he took responsibility, did not have a good fourth quarter, and was not able to fill the role of the closer. But he blamed it on the defensive end just as much as the offensive end. Lee again wide open, 0 for 2 from that spot.
Thing I like about Brian, people said, hey, he hit the wall. He said, if I hit the wall, believe it, I'm going to run through it. That's a guy committed.
And a foul on the pass. Brian arrived very early here in the game, as usual, taking the extra reps, extra shots.
You know, it happens all the time. You lose a tough game to a very good team on the road, and all of a sudden, Kobe Bryant's tired. He didn't play well for fatigue. Are you kidding me? He's not tired.
He's the one guy that didn't go there. Everybody else talked about it. Phil Jackson said he looked it. But Bryant said, I'm fine. He didn't even want to discuss it. To his credit, Ariza for three. Too strong.
I tell you what, as a coach, there's certain guys that you worry about. Kobe Bryant is not one of them.
Hey, sometimes the other team just wins. They beat you. The L.A. Lakers did not lose last game. Orlando won.
And again, the shooting was terrific, but Stan Van Gundy, as Lewis backs in and lost the ball, said the reason they shot so well is because they got quality shots. The ball movement was superb. Ariza down low. Gasol blocked by Howard. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Gasol. His first rejection of the game.
This is how you compete on the defensive end. Give up nothing. Dwight Howard, without the foul, meets Pau Gasol above the rim, comes up with a clean block.
Gasol didn't miss many shots in game three. He was 9 for 11. Looked for the Lakers to go to him a lot more and a lot earlier. Lee spots up for three. Knocks that one down. Boy, you gotta like that. The rookie missed two in a row. No hesitation there.
And that's exactly what I like most about it. Forget about your last two shots. Those are good shots. You're wide open. Step up and knock down the third one.
And I'm gonna tell you, the growth, Mike, is Howard's pass. That pass off the dribble, amazing.
Lee tried to save it, but could not.
He could not do this 2 years ago. Face up, drive it, and off the dribble, put it right on target. Great spacing, great pass, and like you guys both said, good job by Lee not turning it down.
Tough pass for a rookie, starting in the finals and guarding Kobe Bryant. Fisher with four on the shot clock, hand in his face, rattles it in. Fisher continues to shoot well in these finals. There's Lewis, Turkoglu. Back up to Alston, good ball movement again. Lee, not that time, too strong. Rebound tip, nearly taken by Howard, he's got it, puts it up, misses the layup, gets it back again, up strong, won't go, but a foul. And a big smile from Howard as he'll go to the free throw line where he's spent considerable amount of time in this finals.
We watched Dwight Howard on the defensive end with the block shot, offensively chasing down loose rebounds, active underneath. This is when he's most effective, creating havoc in the paint.
And I think his rebounding effort is so critical on the offensive end because you're not going to shoot great every night. And he's the one guy that can give him extra chance points. But I love what Orlando's done offensively. They've gotten the same shots as they did in last game. And they're passing the ball right on target. Lee has just missed.
Stan Van Gundy talking about Howard and his improvement at the free throw line. Again, during the regular season, 59%, but 68 here in the finals. He's taken 41 free throw attempts the first three games, plus add these two. He's got nice form. Lots of times he goes up there and they're perfect. He would have short arms at some time at the end.
Good form may be a stretch. Pretty good. Okay.
Nice rotation on the ball.
All right.
Lee goes for the fake. Shot is up. Won't go, but a foul. Courtney Lee, Michael Petras, who run the majority of guarding Kobe Bryant, have been going for those fakes all series. So tough not to go for it. And Petras quickly comes up as Lee has two.
You know, and as a coach, it's frustrating. But if I'm Courtney Lee or Petras, I say, hey, this guy is great, coach. You come out here and try to guard him. I guarantee you'll fall for the bait every once in a while. But you have to be disciplined on the defensive end and force him to make that shot.
You saw the numbers as Lee sits down. Kobe Bryant, 5 of 10 from the free throw line. That's not the worst he's had in the playoffs. Last year in the first round, he actually shot 4 for 10 in a game, but struggled. And he said his problem was that his elbow wasn't up. Even the ones that went down, he said, were like crawlers. You don't expect him to have another one of those.
Well, some guys miss free throws for an entire career and don't figure out what's wrong. It only took him one night.
Well, Bryant hits his first two tonight. Just over 3 minutes gone by, and already some foul trouble for Orlando. Michael Petras quickly in the game. Turkoglu on the drive all the way to the basket, lays it in, and a foul. Pretty left hand. He doesn't get there quickly, but he gets there.
Well, nice little adjustment. Moved Rashard Lewis to the right-hand corner so there was no shot blocking as Turkoglu drove to his left. Those are the minor adjustments you can make in your spacing to get better shots.
What's most important to me, watching him come off that pick and roll, he is going at a straight line to the basket, so eliminates the possibility of Bynum or Gasol to meet him at the rim. A good job of exploding to his point.
And Bynum, once again, a quick exit, picks up two quick fouls, so both teams some foul problems early for starters.
See, if you're a coach, you should have the right to say, no, that's not really, we'll take the foul, but keep him in. Because we got a better chance of defending them if you're the Magic with Bynum in the game versus Oda.
Bryant fires away. Too strong again. Howard already with five rebounds. Boston had that red hot start in his first four from the field. Spins, drives, layup, no good. Howard trying to keep it alive. Another offensive board. Howard stripped down low. And Orlando will have it underneath.
His effort on the offensive board right now is great, as Derek Fisher looks like he took a blow to the head.
Fisher never afraid to mix it up down low. And he is shaken up. Veteran, after struggling shooting early in the playoffs, has found his stroke. He's done some good things in these finals. Let's watch. You see as him and Howard went for the rebound. How many point guards you see in there battling Dwight Howard?
Stan Van Gundy upset because they called the foul, not in the act of shooting. Certainly making his case that Dwight Howard should be shooting two free throws, and I agree.
Turkoglu kicks it out nicely. Again, good ball movement. Beatrice off the dribble. Austin wide open. Odom runs at him, hits him, and a three-point foul for Lamar Odom. Austin will go to the line for those three free throws.
And going back to that previous play of Dwight Howard where he's battling against Fisher, he's got to keep the ball up so it can't be stripped. And this should be a three-shot foul, but I love... What? Oh, they called it not on the shot. I think they called it against Dwight, whoever was guarding Dwight Howard.
So the foul is against Gasol. My mistake, not against Odom. And offensive foul, Howard clearing some space as Gasol draws the charge. First foul on Howard. These two have been battling pretty good. That one's a tough one.
I hate those calls right there. Let the men play like men.
They've done that most of the way in these finals. Gasol blocked by Howard. Odom takes it right away and lays it in.
In that situation, Dwight Howard is working too hard for the other guys on the floor to let him down. They have to get after the basketball, looking to secure it. That's the end of the defensive trip.
Hold him in the game early with the foul trouble. You'd find him. And as we've been saying throughout, sometimes that's not a bad thing for the Lakers, the way Odom has played. Although not a great game three. Turkoglu to the basket again. Vito Turkoglu, nice drive. And the Magic back up by one.
Well, Turkoglu is as good as it gets as far as a frontline guy in pick and roll situations.
Good defense from Beatrice. Turkoglu. Austin, a little skip. That's a three-pointer. Puts it in. Second three of the game for the Magic. Backs in. Good defense from Howard. Fisher's five on the shot clock. Well short. Lakers just 3 of 10 to start, and they tried to lob it into Howard. Wasn't expecting it. And a second turnover. Make that the third turnover for the Magic.
I thought that was a good look by Turkoglu. Just a miscommunication, but a good run of the floor. I think Dwight Howard in this first 6 minutes has played harder than at any time in this series.
Couple of block shots, 7 rebounds. It's just a ferocity to him to start the game. We're at the midway point of the first. Bryant to the basket, drive, shot's good, out of foul. Chance for the three-point play for Kobe Bryant. Beatrice is first.
It was a very good move by Bryant. A missed help by Turkoglu. He's got to put his whole body in front. But that's just a tremendous finish as he's getting ridden off of his shot.
Well, you're right, Coach, but Turkoglu, your job is to stop the penetration. Your job is not to defend your man. That's the helper helping you. Bad job by Turkoglu stopping Kobe Bryant.
Exactly. Who is he guarding? Lamar Odom. You want them to kick it out into a Lamar Odom jump shot.
Kobe Bryant gave credit to the Magic defenders from game three. Missed 11 of his last 14 from the field after that great start. Said they worked like a dog defensively through the kitchen sink, put a body on me. But they played a great game defensively. Odom gets right up on Turkoglu. And a little too aggressive out on the perimeter. So Odom picks up the foul and we'll have a timeout.
Well, Dwight Howard, good sprint of the floor, looking for the steal, doesn't get the ball. Good effort on the second shot, multiple jumps, stripped on the way up, but seven rebounds, two blocks. Magic up one due to Howard's effort.
On ABC, brought to you by Funny People, from the director of The 40-Year-Old Virgin and Knocked Up, in theaters July 31st. Taco Bell, think outside the bun. Bing, the first ever decision engine from Microsoft. And Vitamin Water, in case you didn't know, Kobe and Dwight definitely get their vitamins.
Welcome back to Orlando with the Magic leading by one. Well, the question can be asked, how does a team bounce back from a finals worst shooting performance in game one to a finals best in game three? Well, for the Orlando Magic, it has as much to do with the characters in their locker room as it does their character. As every player on this team knows, no one is taken too seriously. Hedo Turkoglu found that out in a recent film session.
He was just in the locker room watching film, and he was arguing with coach talking about he closed out on Trevor Ariza, which he didn't.
Today when he came in, I said, hey, it's one of the clips on the film. When we get to it, what we'll do is we'll show it twice and we'll vote on it.
And we watched it on film over and over, and we voted that he didn't close out, but he still joked with coach, man, I had my hand up.
So then he started what the little kids do, which is, well, a lot of other guys didn't close out either.
That's just the way the Magic do things. They have so much fun. We've heard the expression, he has his game face on. Well, for the Magic, the game face is a big fat smile. It's not for everyone, but it works for this Orlando Magic team.
I love the fact that I played on teams where you don't want to go to those film sessions. The Orlando Magic get a 24-second shot clock violation. You didn't want to go because you don't want to be exposed. The great thing about it, the ability to laugh at yourself, but also get work done while you're there.
And if I had a vote, up eight in the fourth quarter, that's not a closeout. I'm voting against Turkoglu.
I think Turkoglu even knows that.
I hope so.
At some point, give it up, Turkoglu.
Right? Even the Prime Minister of Turkey would vote against that closeout right there.
And you bring him up. He got a call, Turkoglu did, from the Prime Minister earlier today, wishing him luck. Kobe Bryant, the turnaround shot won't go. I asked Turkoglu, is that the first time? He goes, oh, no, we talked to him. We talked to him on a pretty much regular basis.
He didn't call him to wish him good luck. He said, close out harder against Ariza.
Head of state giving you a call. Hey, Mark, the president ever call you before a game?
Yeah, I sent him a voicemail because I was working.
Odom, oh, nice right hand, but too strong. And Howard the rebound. Howard already with nine boards. Austin knocks it down.
Well, Ray Austin talked about being more aggressive and confident on the offensive end. It's a good job of realizing he was playing too tentative. He has come ready to play the last two balls.
Odom jump shot. That won't go. Lakers struggling from the field. Offensive rebound blocked by Howard. His third rejection, and gets it out to Alston. What a start for Dwight Howard. Alston the drive. Flips it up and puts it in. He thought he was drawing a foul and put up the floater. And a five-point lead now for Orlando.
Dwight Howard can't play better than he's playing and only score 1 point.
Odom. Nice move from Lamar Odom.
The important thing for me is the Magic, they've got to play this way the entire game long, because there's going to come a point where it's going to get tight. They can't slow it down. Continue to push the battle.
There were no big leads in game three. A foul on the entry pass. That's going to be Gasol's second. So Pau Gasol and Andrew Bynum both with two.
So, and that's the problem. If Bynum gets in foul trouble, then Gasol has to go to guard him. And this is good deep position, good entry pass by Lewis.
So that's why you don't get upset with the referees via Dwight Howard for the offensive foul, because Pau Gasol has a claim also thinking that wasn't a foul. It'll all balance out. Understand that it's a long game. Continue to play.
And I agree with you. To me right there, it's again, let the men play.
All right, way off on that. Let's look at the other play. As DJ Bengus checks in for the first time.
Well, Howard's got one, so good contest. Blocks it with the left hand, gets it out, and then Rafer Alston. Good defense by Fisher. Good finish by Alston.
So Benga getting some minutes because of the foul problems. Benga in the playoffs has only played 12 total minutes. Only played 2 minutes here in these finals. A seven-footer from the Congo now in his fifth year in the NBA. 28-year-old, played pro ball in Belgium. Has not really received any kind of major minutes since coming to the NBA. He's played with Dallas, Golden State, and now the Lakers.
If your peach is defending Kobe Bryant, recognize who's on the floor with him. He has to carry this Laker offense.
Trevor Ariza way off the mark. The Lakers struggling. 5 of 17. Meanwhile, the Magic, a good start again. They're 54%. Turkoglu very aggressive going to the basket, lost it. And a whistle and a foul, and Turkoglu will shoot free throws as Ariza is called for his first. Will Jackson, who in game two, by the way, Jackson won his 41st NBA Finals game. Just Finals game. And that passed Brett Auerbach for most Finals victories as a head coach. Of course, he's got a chance to pass Red if the Lakers win the championship this year. They're both tied with 9 titles. It's amazing. 41 Finals victories. An amazing accomplishment.
Well, you think about it, too. He was having a hard time way back breaking into the NBA. Give Jerry Krause and Doug Collins credit for initially hiring him in Chicago. And then this guy, I don't want to hear about him just having great players. Of course you're going to have great players if you're going to win. He has maximized the talent at hand.
When you think about it, he's won 9 of the last 18 championships. Just incredible. Jordan, Bryant, Shaq, who cares? He's still winning it. Bryant drills it. Kobe Bryant with his 3rd field goal.
That's right in front of us, Coach. That is an absolute tough shot.
Turkoglu again, a penetration. Tony Petit's in, played some good minutes in game 3, way short there. And a loose ball foul will go against the Lakers. Howard had position. And see who the foul is. Might be against Odom, and that's his 2nd. And then a technical foul is called on Trevor Ariza. A little frustration early for the LA Lakers. You can't do that. Bennett Salvatore hit him with a tee. Right now, Orlando by 3.
Thanks for watching ESPN on ABC, home of the NBA Finals.
Brought to you by Vizio.
Popovich talks all the time about when you get to this level, meaning the NBA Finals, how hard it is to win a game. We know they're going to attack the glass. Our will to keep them off the glass has to be stronger than theirs to get everything physically and mentally into this game. Everything. Okay? Everything you've got, every possession. Everything you got. Let's go.
Man, we got, baby. Championship. 1, 2, 3. Championship.
Well, message delivered. Message received. Dwight Howard has played in hard in this 9-minute stretch as I've seen in this finals from him. NBA, beware. If he ever plays with this energy and passion consistently with his strength and athleticism, you have no chance. This is tremendous effort and a dominating effort, only scoring 1 point. 11 rebounds, 3 blocks, and just really giving it all he has.
You look at the numbers, the 11 rebounds. That's just wanting it more. As Hedo Turkoglu will go to the free throw line and shoot the technical foul. Then they'll shoot 2 on the personal foul. By the way, the record for most rebounds in a single quarter in any game, playoffs or regular season, 19. The great Bill Russell did it back in 62 in the NBA Finals.
Wilt never didn't have that, huh?
Not 19.
That's unbelievable. I thought Wilt had every rebounding record.
Meanwhile, coming up at halftime, speaking of Bill Russell, an interesting conversation between the former great big man and the current great big man, Howard and Bill Russell, sitting down and chatting. That's coming up at half.
as Howard to the line for the two free throws.
And if I was Howard after that start, I would have said I should shoot the technical free throw.
That's a good point. The interesting thing for me when you look at the way that this guy is letting it all out, Stan Van Gundy at some point, he's got to give him a rest. There's no way you can play at this level for 48 minutes. The question is, who behind him is going to bring that same type of energy?
And if you're coaching, there's no way you let him get to the free throw line of that.
Yeah, like you're right about that. But when he raises his hand for a rest, that's when you're getting a sip of water. You're looking down. You don't want to see that he needs some rest.
Jordan Farmer in the game. Farmer had some good moments. Farmer in game three. Benga again playing. Gasol and Bynum each with two quick fouls. Shot clock down to four. Long three. Farmer can't connect. And Howard will let that one go out of bounds.
See, this is an easier lineup for the Magic to defend. The job is to force the ball away from Bryant and make the other guys on the floor score.
Small lineup. I mentioned Gasol and Bynum. Odom also with the two fouls. Bill Jackson not wanting any of them to get the third one here in the first. So an interesting lineup to say the least. With Walt, Ariza, Bryant, and Farmar, and then Benga. Well, as you mentioned, it's hardly played in the playoffs. Austin Howard. Wild pass. That's the sixth turnover for Orlando. None for the Lakers, but they've dominated in every other department.
But he had the right idea. The difference was Luke Walton did a great job of coming over and rotating, forcing that turnover.
Austin up on Farmar. Foul. It's going to go against Roy for Austin. His first. He's not the penalty yet. They'll take it out.
Last game was a shootout right off the bat. This game is more of a defensive struggle. That's why every game takes its own personality on, and you can't try to arrive too much from one game other than the adjustments.
And Petras calls for the foul. Kobe Bryant, he does that so well. The defender thinks he's fine. All of a sudden, he gets his hands underneath. And he just said, don't pull me on that.
Don't point at me.
Oh, don't point at me. You better lip reader. Let's see.
That's a foul.
There's no question about it. And that's the same thing that, you know, talking to Stan Van Gundy, he said that our guys have to make sure their hands are up. Once you see the right hand of Petras down below the waist of Kobe Bryant, Bryant does a good job of swinging and coming up. That is a foul, the correct call.
Petras, what a playoffs he's had. Defensively, he's had to guard Andre Iguodala with Philadelphia, Paul Pierce with Boston, LeBron James with Cleveland, and now Kobe Bryant. And although he's had some nights where his opponents had some big nights against him, he's done a heck of a job defensively, plus some real strong nights on the offensive end as well. Turkoglu, minute and a half left in the first. The drive, oh, that's a nice hesitation move. I wouldn't say he floated in the air, but he got rid of Ariza. He's 3 for 3.
That's a shot you work on every day. That's a shot Steve Nash has mastered, fading away from the contest.
Walton fouled on the pass. Tony Battee hit him. And Walton will shoot two.
And it's a great move, not just the fadeaway, but also the strength to eliminate Benga and then fade away and the touch. Outstanding move by Turkle.
The Prime Minister would be very proud of that shot.
Prime Minister's probably taking credit for that shot. I caught him that on the playground.
Coming up, game 5 Sunday on ABC. Again, an earlier start. Our coverage begins at 7:30 Eastern, tip off shortly after 8, and game 5 right back here at Amway Arena. And if the Orlando Magic win tonight, we'll definitely have a game 6 Tuesday on ABC, as the series will shift back to Los Angeles, and a game 7 if necessary, also in LA next Thursday. Right now, the Magic with a 4-point lead coming up on a minute remaining in the first. Austin, nice move, and the floater. How about Ray Austin again in the first quarter? He's 4 for 5 from the field.
really the difference, Coach. He's coming off looking to score, great hesitation, freezing the defense, and then finish.
Walker. Josh Powell also in the game, and he's called for travel. You did not expect here in game four of the finals for the Lakers to have Josh Powell and Benga in the first quarter. With foul trouble, has forced Phil Jackson to use some seldom-used reserves.
All three front court players have two fouls.
Austin, and Benga throws it back. Stan Van Gundy wanted a goaltender. Bryant calling for it. J.J. Redick guarding in. Bryant jump shot, puts it in.
Wow.
Well, he had 17 in the first quarter of game three. He's got 13 here in game four. 13 of their 20 points. Shot clock turned off. Tony Petit, Redick fires away at the buzzer and won't go. And that will end the first period. Dwight Howard came out with a force. 11 rebounds and three block shots. Dominant down low, and perhaps more importantly, he got some Laker big men in foul trouble. Odom, Bynum, Gasol, all with three fouls early, all went to the bench. Part of the reason the Magic have a four-point lead after one.
Again, your guys in a little bit of foul trouble. What positions are putting them there?
I don't know. You know, they're just getting tangling up in there. I don't know what the referees are seeing out there in this first quarter. There's some bogus calls out there, I thought. But, you know, we got both all our big guys in trouble. Lamar, you know, and Powell and DJ, and, excuse me, and Drew. So we're going to be in a deficit now starting out with these guys in foul situation. We survived it. You know, we got to come back down and play our game.
Outside of Kobe Bryant, you're having trouble manufacturing offense. What do you do on that end?
Well, you know, we've got what we want going right now in the game. It doesn't matter to us. We're doing exactly what we think is necessary.
Mike.
All right, Doris. So because of those foul problems, and again, those three each have two fouls. And you see Gasol back in. Josh Powell, who played 3 minutes so far in the finals, and Benga, who had played two, getting some early action. Benga back on the bench as we get set to start the second.
Interesting move by Phil Jackson, Coach. I would certainly have Josh Powell defending Dwight Howard as opposed to Powell Gasol, the danger of picking up his third foul.
That's a tough call because obviously as Jameer Nelson goes in and gets a layup, he probably hasn't guarded many men of size, but I agree with you. The more time you can buy Gasol, the better served you may be.
Nelson, who has not played well in the limited minutes, struggled in game three. Well, the team played pretty well when he was on the floor. We have a foul away from the ball.
And Mike, I think Orlando's playing exceptionally hard, but they have to play with a higher IQ. The fouls they're committing, both on Bryant and now Batiste's two fouls against Luke Walton, are just not smart fouls.
Courtney Lee, Michael Petras, and Batiste each with two now for Orlando. Walton on the drive. Vujicic puts it up. Strong. Won't go, and a rebound goes to Nelson. Nice boxing out from Tony Petit.
And also a good job by the perimeter guys. Nelson getting in and helping.
Nelson's jump shot missed by about a foot. It has been a struggle for him coming back after the surgery on his shoulder, missed 4 months. He says, I'm not myself. I haven't been aggressive. First two times he's got the ball, he's pretty aggressive, although obviously unable to knock it down.
Well, I was very impressed with him last game, how he put his body on the line and got in the mix, like you just said, on rebounding situation.
Vujicic again. That won't go. And a rebound goes to Nelson. Vujicic's nightmare shooting in these postseason has really been tough for him. And a 3 second violation. Howard was sitting there for a long time, and they just didn't see him right away.
But he's wide open. But if you're Dwight Howard, you don't get the basketball, you got to recognize, get out of the paint, and then get back in. At some point, Pau Gasol says, are you kidding me? That's 6 seconds.
But I understand his frustration. He is wide open as Luke Walton knocks it in. And they've got to be able to deliver it.
Well, the Magic have outshot the Lakers by a lot and have out-rebounded them by a lot, but the turnovers have hurt. 7-1. 7 for Orlando, just the 1 for the Lakers. Redick off the dribble. Rattles it in. J.J. Redick couldn't play at all in game 3. Well, it knocks down that shot.
But you can tell that a point of emphasis for the Orlando Magic is pick and roll situations. The ball handler has got to look to be aggressive, look to score. They're certainly doing that.
Josh Powell won't go. Howard with his 12th rebound. Knocks down his buddy in the process. Lewis for 3. Powell Gasol, quick outlet. Jackson said they can play any tempo. They're successful up-tempo. It goes in a half court as well. Vujicic likes the up-tempo game. Gasol. His first field goal.
When he makes that jump shot, he's so difficult to defend because if you close on him, he has the ability to drive the ball by you.
Redick again off the dribble. Finds Petit wide open. Petit likes that shot and connects again.
Tell you what, outstanding feed from J.J. Redick. Good job of getting into the seams and then delivering the basketball on point.
Redick, one of the great scorers in college basketball history. This year has become more of a facilitator for Stan Van Gundy. Farmar gets it into Walton. Walton triple team, looking for an opening. Finds Vujicic. Back to Farmar. Nice little fake. That's a 3. And hits the shot clock. Magic ball. Lakers now 0-6 from downtown.
Redick making plays. Dribble penetration on point to Petit. Knocks down the jumper. And he's not finished there. This JJ is having a good time. In rhythm. Knocks down the J. Dynamite.
Provided by Goodyear. New Fuel Max tires get you there on less gas. 3 minutes gone by, second quarter of game 4. Magic lead Lakers 30-24 here on June 11th, 2009. 10 years ago, the Eastern Conference Finals, game 6. Mark Jackson, Patrick Ewing, Larry Johnson. It was the Pacers and the Knicks. Jackson with a nice little jumper. Boy, he looks thin. Jeff Van Gundy, the head coach of the 8-seeded Knicks. Allen Houston had, maybe considering the importance of the game, his best game as a pro. He was spectacular, unstoppable. And the Knicks were able to win it 90-86 and head to the NBA Finals as the number 8 seed, where they would face the San Antonio Spurs. All right, Jeff, you first. What do you remember most?
Allen Houston was beyond great in that game. Closing the game down the stretch. He got any shot he wanted. And then I remember Mark Jackson making a 3 to cut it to 5 with like 40 seconds. And Allen Houston was backed up under the 3-point line. I thought I was going to lose my mind.
Mark?
I remember beating them the other times. I don't recall that one.
Turkoglu, pretty move. Vito Turkoglu with 12 points. He's 4-for-4 from the field.
And then the next year they beat us in game 6 at home to go to the finals.
Bannon Brown is coming. Gasol, nice move right at court time. The Lakers have played all 12 guys already. Lewis, nice pass inside. Pretty feed. Mark Finnan-Wartak gives him an 8-point lead, the largest of the first half.
There's been times in this first half where the Magic ball movement has been as good as we've seen.
Walton got bumped. And they're going to call it in the act, so he'll shoot 2 free throws.
These are the fouls that I'm talking about. You cannot be given, as we watch Gortat on the roll. That's a nice pass by Lewis and a good catch and finish by Gortat. But on the other end, to foul Luke Walton on the drive instead of making him finish, that's just not sound basketball by Turkoglu. He's got to make him make.
Turkoglu was his first foul. As Walton misses the first free throw.
But I totally agree with you, Coach. That's a tough play for Luke Walton. Trust that your defense has done the job and force him to make that shot.
And what Turkoglu is trying to do is make it harder to get an entry pass into the paint.
Lewis for 3. It's a 10-point lead for the Orlando Magic. Lewis's first field goal.
But you know, if Jameer Nelson comes off that pick and roll just running the play, the defense doesn't react. Because he comes off the score, it leaves the open shot for Lewis.
Wertok picks it up and then throws it out of bounds. This is the largest lead of the finals for Orlando. They had that 9-point advantage early in the fourth quarter of game three, their first double-digit lead of this series.
But the turnovers are preventing them from having an even larger margin. They played great, minus that aspect, but that's like, you can't play great if you're turning it over that much.
Eight turnovers to just one. Fisher's back in. Fisher, Odom, Gasol, and Bryant. And Luke Walton, four of the five starters, have returned for the Lakers. Odom takes it to the basket, right-handed. Wertok may have gotten a piece of it. Ball still loose. Lewis picks it up. Here come the Magic. Nelson was open. Turkoglu didn't see him. He wants to take Walton to the basket. Redick, open again. And Lewis grabs it. Bryant takes it back. Good hustle play from Kobe Bryant. Crowd wanted a foul. Gasol, quick spin move. Right at Gortat and drops it down.
And how good is Pau Gasol? You talk about showing us everything on the offensive end. Knockdown, jump shot, dribble penetration that time. Fundamentally sound on the post.
Nelson to the basket. Can't get the reverse to go. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Gasol. Nelson pleading for a foul.
Talking about a skilled big man with patience. Spins to the baseline. Nothing there. Little dream move coming back to the middle. Regains his balance and the sweet jump hook.
That's a great defensive job as well.
Turkoglu. Rebounding numbers. 17-9. Odom to the basket. Can't get that sweeping shot to go. Gasol knocked down. He's arguing with Scott Foster as he comes up the floor. Just past the midway point of the second. Another strong start for the Orlando Magic. Turkoglu draws the foul on Odom. And that's three fouls on Lamar Odom. He's upset with Bennett Salvatore.
Well, as much as the Magic have reacted to Kobe Bryant's shot fakes, the Lakers have reacted to Turkoglu. To me, that's a good call. You got to stay down and make people make shots. And I love this piece of officiating. Let the big men battle. Kobe Bryant front in the low post. Rashard Lewis trying to get it. Then when the ball's in the air, both guys fighting for it. That's good basketball by both guys.
ABC, brought to you by Year One, starring Jack Black and Michael Cera, in theaters June 19th, rated PG-13. The third generation Prius. Axe Hair, get girl-approved hair. And the most valuable puppets. See them at NikeBasketball.com.
We survived that quarter, right? We got to play better basketball than that. Stop the ball. Stop the ball. It's all penetration. Stop the drivers.
The Magic playing hard even after the victory. Kobe Bryant. A lot of people told him after game three, hey, the Magic set a shooting finals record and barely won. Kobe says to his teammates, don't listen to that stuff.
Don't sit here and think, oh, this team shot 75% in the first half, 62.5% for the game, and they only won by two. Don't think that way, because this team can shoot 70-60% for weeks at a time. And that's why they're here. It's not an aberration. It's not, oh, they had a hot night. It's they can do this for a long time. So we got our work cut out for ourselves to try to slow that down.
Well, they're not shooting it at the pace they did in game three, but still pretty strong, 52% from the field.
That sounds like a coach to me right there. Seriously, that's what a coach would say after a game. Is don't let all that noise coming at you about, oh, they can't do that again. Don't buy into that.
Let's check in with Doris.
guys, real frustration on the Lakers staff with the blown coverages. There's two ways they're trying to guard the Magic offense, and the guys are confusing it. So the Lakers right now not understanding or not at least executing what the game plan is, guys.
Bynum back in. Quick shot is good. Bynum barely played before he picked up his second foul. Takes his first shot attempt. 7-point Orlando lead. Good health defense there from Bynum. Redick, nice pass. Gortat, the finish. J.J. Redick setting up his teammate beautifully again.
You know, I was telling Mark at the last time out, J.J. Redick has really improved since he's come into the NBA. He's a solid defender. He doesn't make mistakes. He puts it on the floor better. He's a better passer. He just hasn't found the ability to shoot as well as he did in college.
So ironic. Such a great shooter, such a great scorer. But a completely different role now. Gasol stripped down low by Turkoglu and knocked out of bounds.
That's a good job of coming off the pick and roll. That's fundamental basketball. The drop pass off to Gortat. He gave great minutes in replacement for Dwight Howard, sustained the energy. And I love the fact that the Magic on the defensive end, they are competing.
Off the turnover. Howard throws it ahead. Here comes Redick. Waits, slips. Turkoglu right there to clean it up. Even on a broken play, it works for the Magic, who go up by 11. Down the other end, Ariza. Howard got a piece of it. Gasol blocked from behind, but a foul. And Rashard Lewis upset with the call. A little bit of Murphy's Law right now for the Orlando Magic.
My mom told me when it rains, it pours. Good things happen when you work extremely hard. The Magic's certainly doing that. Redick tripping, come up with the basket.
And a technical foul on the Laker bench. I don't know if it was Phil Jackson or Frank Hamblin, the assistant. There's Hamblin, one-time head coach. Long-time NBA man. He was hot. They announced it that it's against Phil Jackson. Either way, it's a technical free throw from Redick.
When I talk about competing on the defensive end, two possessions ago, J.J. Redick defended Kobe Bryant. Works his tail off as far as denying contestants. Bryant drops it off to Pau Gasol being defended by Turkoglu. Two guys that technically are overmatched, but they competed and they came up with a stop.
So now Gasol will shoot the two free throws on the personal foul. Last foul on Lewis was his first. Gasol 6 points. Misses that. You know, Redick, again, we talk about the adjustment. He said it's been a humbling experience going from being the guy at Duke to being a role player, sometimes not playing. And he even admitted, he said, I needed to be humble. But he kept working at it. He's been a good teammate. And as you guys have said, he's improved in so many other ways to have an impact on this team's success.
If you look at him athletically, he's not overly talented for an NBA player. He's small, he's a little bit slower, but the guy competes.
Austin misses a three, Gasol the rebound. Ariza. Bryant, a long three, drills it. Kobe Bryant, big shot, he's got 16, and that cuts it to 8.
Kobe Bryant scares me. When he's on the floor, it's almost like, hey, it's okay, everything's gonna be all right, guys.
A blocking foul on Bynum. Some frustration for the Lakers. Three on Andrew Bynum.
Well, this guy is the bully walking in the alley with everybody else. He just gives you confidence. Even when things are going bad, the ability to make plays and put a team on his back, you got to pay attention to Bynum.
There's no question. They play with his guts. You know, when he establishes himself as so good, you just get carried away with the emotion. You always know, the bully's got my back.
That's right.
And an offensive foul, Lewis, a moving screen. The officials are now telling players on both teams to stop complaining. Lewis and Derek Fisher have some words. Fisher walks away with a smile. So Lewis picks up his second. Michael Petras is going to come back, and Redick's going to sit down. Redick, 3 points and three assists off the bench and some good hustle plays.
And this is a big 352 for the Orlando Magic.
you want to have something to show for an outstanding first half. Don't allow the Lakers to gain momentum.
And if you weren't looking at the score, you'd think the Magic were up by a pretty big number. It's only an 8-point game.
But it's the turnovers, Mike. You have double-digit turnovers. It's hard to establish a big lead.
Gasol, back out Fisher. Good open look for three. Short, rebound tipped. Good pursuit by Gasol to help keep that alive. Bryant, Petras on him. Petras has two fouls. Bryant pulls up. Too strong on the jumper. Ow, the rebound, but lost it to Turkoglu. Lewis shoots over Powell. Three-pointer won't go. Howard keeps it alive for his 13th rebound of the half. Howard against Gasol. Backs in up top. Turkoglu. Little fake. Drives again. Petras. That's a three. Howard is fouled by Powell. Howard tried to put it back in. Powell hit him. And a timeout will be called. An 8-point lead for the Orlando Magic as they try and tie this series up tonight.
Well, it's just good work by Dwight Howard from start to finish. Active on the offensive board, multiple jumps. This is how you want work if you want to be a great big guy. Ball comes in, he throws it out. Instead of standing, he keeps on the move. The ball goes up, air ball pass to him, 14 rebounds. That's a career for a lot of guys.
I think about the trophy all the time. It's one of the most precious items that could ever be given to you. To have it in my hands would be like a dream coming true.
Playing for an NBA championship, and 23-year-old Dwight Howard, already in his fifth year in the league. And again, they're bottling him up in terms of scoring, but he came out with a force. 14 rebounds, as many as the entire Laker team. He also has four block shots, a big part of why the Magic up by eight. And he'll shoot some free throws right now with 2:46 remaining here in the second. Howard will get to the line again. He's only 2 for 6. He's done an excellent job from the line for him during this series, but not tonight so far. Nobody attempted more free throws during the regular season, and that one won't go as well. You don't want to tell people about a special announcement. We see the two coaches today vying for a championship. Well, another coach who won a couple of championships with the Celtics received an award today. It was announced the Coaches Association announced the Chuck Daly Lifetime Achievement Award. The Hall of Famer, of course, who just recently passed away. We've had those pins on the lapels throughout the playoffs. Well, they established a Lifetime Achievement Award in his name. And Tommy Heinsohn, the former Celtic coach, now broadcaster, is the first recipient of the Chuck Daly Lifetime Achievement Award. And certainly deservedly so, a man who's dedicated his whole life to the NBA.
Well, because he's such a great announcer now with the Boston Celtics, you forget how good a coach he was. I mean, he coached some great, great teams led by Dave Cowens. As another illegal screen is called.
That's on Josh Powell, his second. Great coach, wonderful broadcaster, and some kind of player as well.
Well, and also, Mike, you know, with all this stuff that, you know, for Chuck Daly, all he did, Tommy Heinsohn emulated him and what he brought to the Coaches Association. He started the pension program for the coaches. So it's not just what he did on the floor. It's what he did for so many assistant coaches, you know, who are anonymous but need that pension.
Howard gets it down low. Puts it up left hand and drops it in. That's his first field goal. And it puts the Magic back up by double figures.
You know, there are times where he certainly shows the ability to be a dominant low post scorer. That is a big time post up move that Dwight Howard needs to do more.
Bryant tried to draw the foul here on Petras.
And I think Howard has managed his frustrations very well tonight. Not getting the ball when he's wanted to. Being bumped and hit. Missing free throws. This is big time maturity.
And last foul on Fisher. Here's the play down the other end before.
Now, they didn't come at him as hard on the double team that time because he's shown the willingness to pass it out. And then he countered back to his baseline jump hook, much the same way that Pau Gasol does.
First foul on Fisher. 14 foul on the Lakers. We're under the two-minute mark here in the first half. Howard across the lane. The little hook. Throws it in. Back-to-back buckets for Howard. And it's a 12-point lead for the Magic.
You talk about having a defender off guard. First time is a jump hook with the left hand. All of a sudden, it's a run-hand, one-handed running right shot.
This equals their largest lead. Josh Powell playing minutes with some foul problems for the Lakers. And Powell knocks it down.
And that closeout by Turkoglu on Josh Powell is similar to the one to Ariza. You're playing the score instead of playing the game. You got to close harder to Josh Powell and make him a driver.
And I like the Magic going right back to Dwight Howard on the block. Play inside out.
Howard goes right at Gasol again. Kicks it out. Petras. Petras trying to get Bryant up. Nice defensive play from Kobe Bryant. Ball goes out of bounds, and it's Laker ball. Stay tuned for the finals. Player of the game vote presented by T-Mobile during the second half of tonight's game. Right now, the early leaders are Howard with his 14 rebounds, Turkoglu with his 15 points, Kobe Bryant with his 16 points. Ariza gets inside. Jump ball. Howard does it again. Strong defensive play.
We raved about Kobe Bryant's first half in game three. Dwight Howard has been as impressive without scoring as much.
There's no question. What he's done is remarkable.
They count that as his fifth block. And the tip, 2-on-1. Petras to the basket, up and under. Rose off the rim. A whistle and a foul on Fisher on the play. Didn't even hear the whistle. So Petras will shoot two.
And a great tip by Dwight Howard to ignite that fast break. Tipped it long to give them the automatic 2-on-1. Another good but not often seen play where a tip leads to a fast break.
And here's Petras signed. 4-year, $22 million deal this offseason. They had high hopes. They loved his size and athleticism. But in December and January, he missed about 28 games combined, broke his right wrist, hurt his right thumb, his right knee was bad, injured his ribs. And he really wasn't part of the rotation for a while, lost his starting job. But in the playoffs, he started to get back to it. It's his first year after playing with Golden State. And he has really come on in the playoffs. And he's the guy that's on the floor at crunch time more often than not. Even though he comes off the bench. Bryant for three. And a loose ball foul. It's going to go against Turkoglu, who grabbed Ariza before Howard came flying in. Two fouls on Turkoglu. They're not in the penalty. Turkoglu trying to make his point. We have a 20-second timeout. Turkoglu pleads his case. We'll take a quick break. Magic by 12. Time, Stuart Scott, John Barry, Michael Wilbon, and Magic Johnson. We'll have the T-Mobile halftime report. Told you about that conversation, Dwight Howard and Bill Russell. You'll hear from these two great centers. And then first half analysis of game four from here in Orlando. All on the T-Mobile halftime report.
And Mike, something to look for. Here's where the Lakers, out of the timeout, want to get a quick one, so it'd be a two-for-one situation.
Fisher for three. Too strong. Ball batted around. Powell tips it. Last touch by the Lakers.
But they accomplished what they wanted. 6-second differential. They'll get two shots.
You know, and more importantly, Coach, they got a good look. So you can live with it as a coach when it's a good look.
Lakers 1-for-10 from three-point range. They go to Howard again. Howard across the lane. That sweeping hook off the mark. Rebound fought for. Last touch by Fisher. And now the Magic will hold it for the final shot of the half. And Stan Van Gundy calls a 20-second timeout. The Magic defensively getting it done in the first half. So far, only giving up 37 points.
And then Derek Fisher goes halfway, does a good job rolling away from the half double team, left-handed jump hook over Pau Gasol, putting on a clinic in this first half.
8.9 remaining. Lakers do not have a foul to give as we wind down the second period. The T looking for someone to get it to. Deflected out of bounds by Fisher.
I'm sort of surprised that Stan Van Gundy didn't insert Hedo Turkoglu the last possession offensively, arguably his best offensive guy on the floor.
And they'll look to try to go high-low here to Dwight Howard in the paint.
Ariza guarding the inbounds on Petras, backs off a little bit. Austin gets it. Austin fires a three, off the mark, Powell the rebound, and that will end the first half. In game three, it was the Orlando Magic offense that was sensational. Here in game four, their defense just superb as they hold the Lakers to 37 points and 33% shooting from the field. And they got a huge performance from Dwight Howard, 14 rebounds, 5 block shots. He's with Doris.
Dwight, you did not get your first couple of field goals so late in the second period, yet you had a major influence on the first half. What were you looking to do early?
Well, just try to be aggressive on the defensive end, block shots, rebound, and make it tough for those guys to score. Yeah, but we got two more halves, so we got to keep it up. Well, two more quarters, so we got to keep it up.
Your defense solid in the first half. The Lakers under 40%. What are you doing to influence them on the defensive end?
Well, we're moving our feet. You know, we're not going for a lot of pump fakes, and we're just having fun.
Quite, thank you. Mike?
Well, they always have fun, successful fun here in the first half as they lead by a dozen. After the break, Stuart Scott, John Barry, Michael Wilbon, Magic Johnson, the T-Mobile Halftime Report. You'll hear from Dwight Howard and his conversation he had with the great Bill Russell. And the guys will talk about the first half. And again, a strong one defensively for the Defensive Player of the Year in his Orlando Magic. Halftime of Game 4. Magic trying to tie this NBA Finals at 2 games apiece. Right now they lead 49-37.
We haven't given them anything in transition. Make sure we are getting back all the time and talking to Magic up.
Let's come on out there with the idea of what we want to get accomplished.
Halftime, game four of the 2009 NBA Finals. Dwight Howard and the Orlando Magic 2 quarters away from tying this series up. Lots of basketball left, but right now they're up by a dozen. Good evening once again, everyone, along with Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand. Usually, it's the team that loses the previous game that comes out as the hungrier team in the next game. Not the case tonight. It was the Magic that came out hungrier to start this one.
Well, led by Dwight Howard, I thought they played extremely hard, and Turkoglu had a great first half.
Yeah, that's our Coors Light cold hard look.
Well, you just look at how good this 6'10 wing player is. He drives away from the pick and roll. No help comes. He's going straight to the basket, and he gets the conventional three-point play. And then he splits on the next drive going to his left. He steps by, goes off the wrong foot, and still finds the way to finish. But it really came back to the effort of Dwight Howard that set the tone. He ran, he rebounded, he blocked. He didn't score much. But he showed how big an impact you can make on this game when you're that athletic and play that hard. And he really, really dominated the game. 5 offensive rebounds, 5 block shots, just outstanding energy and effort by Dwight Howard.
And Turkoglu, the all-around game as well. He was very aggressive and had 15 points. Meanwhile, for the Lakers, Mark, the key for them was they got in foul trouble right away.
You talk about that front line. You have to play with force, play smart, and be disciplined. You can't have careless plays on the defensive end. Pau Gasol with 2 fouls. How about Andrew Bynum? Fouling at the wrong time. 3 fouls. Lamar Odom also.
contesting a jump shot, fouls Turkoglu, picks up three fouls. The Laker bigs, they have to find a way to stay on the floor, give themselves a chance.
Kobe Bryant, a lot of scoring in that first half. But you see the rest of the team, 9 of 30 from the field. He always has to find the balance of being aggressive but keeping everybody involved.
And the foul trouble hurts that his ability to do that because they're on the bench so often.
They had some guys. Josh Powell played 8 minutes. Benga played minutes as well as Austin misses the first shot attempt of the third. And there's some very unusual Laker lineups in that first half because of the foul difficulties. That's a two from Fisher and puts it in.
And a bad job by Rafa Austin trying to help Courtney Lee leaving Derek Fisher. Adam contained, your job is to stay at home.
Fisher with a second field goal. Fights over the screen on Austin. Turkoglu, 5 of 6 from the field in that first half. Nice pass to Howard, gets it inside. Lakers a step late on that play.
And coach, those are the type of plays that the Orlando Magic, they've not been able to make. That's coming off a pick and roll and finding Dwight Howard diving to the hoop. That's tough to defend.
Gasol trying to get position down low. Lewis pokes it away. Here comes Courtney Lee. Lee on the drive. Stripped by Bynum, then stolen by Bryant. Out of contact there, and then Turkoglu fouls Bryant to try and prevent the fast break as we send it over to Doris Burke.
Bryant Shaw came out of the locker room and said, compete, compete, compete. He felt like the Magic gave better effort. He said, on the defensive end, hopefully we're on the same page with our rotations. Their emphasis is on keeping the ball out of the middle of the floor. On the offensive end, they're looking for more spacing. They'd like to give Powell a little bit more room. Kobe Bryant had a message for his teammates. As you see, he gets up a little bit slowly here, guys. He said, listen, fellas, we can't try to do things. We have to simply do things. We'll see how they turn out here in the second half.
All right, Doris. He's had some problems with that right hand last couple of years. Tearing some ligaments and never had the surgery. Dislocated it. He got it taped up. Had it taped up throughout.
And interestingly enough, the way he caught the pass from Pau Gasol did not use that right finger.
Gasol trying to pick it up off the floor. Bynum with the jump shot. Way short. Good play from Lee. Here comes Turkoglu.
But Mike, on that last fast break for the Magic, where Courtney Lee turned it over, Turkoglu took an unnecessary foul. Now he has three. That puts him in danger.
Lewis trying to draw the foul. Misses. Bynum the rebound. Knocked away. Taken by Howard. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Bynum. Here's the play as he reached for it. He was okay by then, after when he started looking at it. 2 minutes gone by here in the third, the pivotal game four. Lakers trying to take command of this series as Ariza pokes it away. Trevor Ariza, nice defensive play. Turkoglu in pursuit. And a strong finish.
Ariza does an outstanding job of getting into the passing lane, not giving up on plays, laying on screens. A good job of reading fast break opportunities off his intention.
Growing into one of the better young wing defenders in the NBA. Top 10 in steals this year. He's had some huge steals in the postseason. Howard across the lane. 10-point Orlando lead. Bryant hits a three. And just like that, it's down to 7.
I think the finger's okay.
Well, right now, the Magic, to me, have to pick up their offensive energy. They've got to run it, get it up the floor quicker. Right now, they're playing a little too slow.
Turkoglu finding the open man. It's Lee, and Lee fouled hard. Good hard foul from Fisher to prevent any kind of dunk as he picks up his third foul.
Kobe Bryant on the floor. You have to defend him like he's 100%. You allow him to push the ball up the floor and step in rhythm at the three-point line, you're going to pay the price. You got to pick him up as soon as he has the basketball.
His 75% would be 150% of most people. This guy, I mean, he's not getting surgery on his hand. He's fine. He's not tired. He's not hurt. He's indestructible.
This is the second. Magic have struggled from the line.
has missed six free throws. Howard's missed five of them. Missed seven, excuse me. Ariza fakes, now drives. Ariza to the basket and knocks it in. Nice play from Trevor Ariza. He was 0 for 6.
But he's hit a couple in a row.
And Bryant taking the double team. But I agree with you, Coach. The magic, we talked about it in the first half. You can't slow it down when the game gets tight. Continue to do things that you've done in the first half that were so effective.
Turkoglu was taking it to the basket effectively in the first half. Trying to draw a foul there, falling away. Oh, he puts it in. Boy, that's a tough, tough shot. He's 6 of 7 from the field. Ariza and Turkoglu, a little duel here in the third. Bryant sees the double team coming. Ariza goes to the open spot and nails a three. Trevor Ariza, three straight buckets for the Lakers, and it's a 5-point game. And Stan Van Gundy wants timeout. And after struggling shooting the ball in the first half, Lakers have come out strong here in the third period and have cut it to 5.
Kobe Bryant just waiting, hoping on the double team. Very soft double team by Turkoglu. No rotation by Rafer Alston. Knockdown 3-point shot by Ariza.
Fills you up. The difference is drinkability. Chevy. Warner Brothers Pictures' Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince, in theaters everywhere Wednesday, July 15th. And Vizio, America's number one HD TV company.
Back in Orlando, just over 4 minutes gone by in the third. The Magic right now with a 5-point lead. Leading scorer is Benito Turkoglu. He's got 17. He's impressed a lot of people in these playoffs, including Kobe Bryant.
He's crafty. You know, he's not the fastest guy in the world. He's not the quickest guy in the world. But one thing that he knows how to do is he knows how to use his body. You know, he handles the ball, knows how to get himself in positions to be effective. And, I like him. I like him as a player.
Turkoglu was born in Istanbul, the first Turkish-born player in NBA history, a first-round pick of the Kings. Played 3 years with Sacramento, 1 year in San Antonio, now his fifth year with Orlando. He can opt out of his contract and become an unrestricted free agent after the season. And the way he's playing, he'll get more than the $7 million that the Magic want to pay him, perhaps. As Alston fires up a three, way short.
I really don't like the way that the Magic playing offense right now. Really not putting pressure on the Lakers D.
Kobe Bryant misses. Good boxing out from Lewis. Alston pushing, trying to get it to Howard. He turned it over. The turnovers have really hurt them. Bryant goes right at Turkoglu. Shot banker won't go. Turkoglu defended it well, but then fouls Ariza on the follow. And that's 4 on Hedo Turkoglu. And Ariza, who already has 7 points in the period, will go to the line for 2.
Well, we can talk about the Magic's offense, but give credit to the Lakers on the defensive end. They certainly have stepped it up. The intensity of the executing and then getting it going in transition that time. Ariza, with the offensive rebound, draws the contact.
When we talk about free agents, Ariza will be one this season, offseason as well. Lakers certainly want to re-sign him. Got to try and re-sign him and Lamar Odom. Two key players who will be free agents. Ariza has had just a fabulous, fabulous playoff run.
It'll be interesting to see who Mitch Kupchak prioritizes to sign in the offseason. Is it Ariza or is it Lamar Odom? Lamar Odom being 30 or 31 years old.
That's a tough choice for Kupchak. You saw him sitting there. Kupchak and Otis Smith of Orlando Magic. Both guys have done a terrific job with their teams as Redick in and out, finding them the rebound. Magic 2 for 7 from the field here in the third. Ariza, that's a three. It's good. Trevor Ariza puts it in. It's a 1-point game. 11 points for Ariza in 5.5 minutes. Alston looking. Lewis tries to answer. Can't get it to go. And Redick knocks it out of bounds.
Well, we raved about the Orlando Magic in the first half. The ball movement, that's picture-perfect ball movement by the Lakers. Bryant taking the double team, delivering it to Powell, and then he makes the extra pass.
And to me, right now in the post, when they have Pietras on him, they probably should take off the double team to make sure they can guard everyone on the floor.
Ariza wants to post up. Instead, we have a foul away from the ball. It's Alston who hit Fisher. Alston second.
And even on this possession, Kobe Bryant chastises Pau Gasol and says, get me the basketball. When you get me the ball, the offense is easy. I will make the proper plays. Double team comes, and guys will have wide open shots. He is running the point guard from the scoring position.
Approaching the midway point of the third. He just falls down. Ariza to the basket. Gets it to Bynum. Bynum lost it. Got it back in his foul as the shot clock expired. It appeared that the whistle and foul came before the 24-second clock finished up. And two free throws for Bynum. Howard's second foul.
And coach, it showed you how great Kobe is. If you single coverage him, he's going to look to score. If you double team him, the guy is making every proper play.
Well, and that's why when people say I've got to pass or shoot more, it's not about that. It's just making the right play as Bynum ties the game. Again, single coverage against smaller players, go to work. Single coverage against Pietras, go to work. They double, pass the ball out.
Bynum hits the free throw, and the Lakers have their first lead since the opening minutes. They trailed by 12 at halftime, and an 18-5 run to begin the third quarter. Lewis, the floater, won't go. Lewis tips it, fight for the ball, knocked out of bounds. Bennett Salvatore didn't see it. Laker ball. That's a tough one. It looked like it may have grazed Lewis last. Bryant comes off the screen, goes up for the jumper, way short. Pietras the rebound. Bryant 6 of 16. Redick to Alston. Fakes the three on the drive, goes to the hole, throws it in. Big bucket from Ray for Alston.
And that's a huge bucket because the question was who was going to stop the bleeding for the Magic. Alston does a great job of not selling for the three-pointer, getting into the seam.
He's the second Magic in double figures with 11. Bynum. Soft touch by the big seven-footer.
And to me right now, Rashard Lewis has got to attack Pau Gasol now.
Bad pass from Alston. Howard, though, takes it away. And then a loose ball foul against the Lakers. Bynum had it. But he winds up picking up the foul because Howard did not give up on the play. Four on Bynum.
Well, Howard's trying to seal early. I didn't see anything.
But. No, and Bynum has a legitimate beef there. But again, you can credit Howard. Even though Bynum was going to get it, Howard kept after it. Lamar Odom back in. Again, Gasol. He has to guard Howard. He's done a good job in this series. That miss. Pietras had it. Lost it. Ball poked away. Fisher diving. The oldest guy on the floor dives and calls timeout. And the Laker bench gets up and greets their veteran leader. So a timeout on the floor with just over 4.5 minutes remaining in the third. A third quarter has been wonderful for Trevor Ariza.
Well, getting wide open shots, making plays in transition, defensively battling. You're going to leave them open to guys to say, I put too much time in not to knock those shots down. Third quarter, Lakers up 20-7. Getting it done.
Back to Orlando. It's not Hollywood, but they've got some celebrities, including Chris Tucker, a huge basketball fan. Rihanna sitting courtside as well. And Mr. and Mrs. Tiger Woods. Tiger, as we've said, a season ticket holder. Time for our Gatorade Cooler Talk. It's with another celeb, a basketball one, Dwayne Wade, with Doris Burke.
Well, Mike, Tiger is a tough act to follow, but we've got the superstar, Dwayne Wade. I think, Dwayne, most people are a little bit surprised it's the Orlando Magic and not the Cleveland Cavaliers in the finals, but you've competed against that team. What was your reaction to them making the finals?
Well, I said all year, you know, this is one team that you don't want to play because, you know, of course with Dwight Howard, but they have four shooters on the floor at all times. So they're always a matchup problem, and, you know, they're one of the best shooting teams in the league.
Talk about Kobe Bryant a bit. Most guys have sounded off about what he was like as a teammate. A little surprised. What were your reactions to playing alongside of him?
I mean, it was one of the best experiences, you know, for me as a basketball player. I got an opportunity to play with one of the greatest players of all time. And the season he's had, you know, to us is what we say. It's been a G year for him because winning the Olympics and now an opportunity to win the championship.
A G year. Tell us how you would check Kobe Bryant.
I just, you know, play up tough, put my hand up when he's shooting, hope he missed. That's the only thing you can do with Kobe is just hope he missed.
Keep his hand up. It's hand down, man down.
Hand down, you're in trouble.
That's right. Thanks, Dwayne. Mike.
All right, Doris, former finals MVP, Dwayne Wade. And the finals MVP now named after Bill Russell. It'll be the Bill Russell Finals MVP Award. And a defensive 3 seconds call, a technical foul, one shot, and Bryant puts the Lakers up two.
I am really worried about Doris Burke. Quoting Mark Jackson, in normal, regular conversation, is the world coming to an end?
It's disconcerting, I'll agree.
That's just getting it done on the side. That's just great work by Doris.
Bryant to Fisher. Fisher for three. Won't go. And Howard, another rebound, his 16th of the game.
Rashard Lewis has got to get going. Somehow offensively, they have no other great options right now.
Lewis double team. Up top to Austin. Shot clock at six. And a whistle. Is it an offensive 3 seconds?
Yep.
That's what it is against Orlando. Another turnover. They're 15th to only four by the Lakers.
But I think that your brother Stan agrees with you because he's trying to get Rashard Lewis going, but Phil Jackson says, hey, I'm going to put Kobe Bryant on him and then we're going to double team him. So they're forcing the ball away from Lewis.
Lakers only had 37 points in the first half. They already have 21 here in the third quarter. We still have 3.5 to go. Odom, the floater. Howard got a piece of it. Shot clock did not reset. Bryant has to put it up. Down to two. Lost the ball. Austin has it. Two on one. Petras. Austin. Petras. Layup. Banks it in. Gasol down the other end. Gasol hasn't taken many shots, only six. Fisher a three. And Lewis the rebound. Magic still with the rebounding edge by six. Austin to the basket, left-handed. And Gasol grabs it.
That's a second left-handed layup.
Boy,
that Rafer Austin has missed in this half.
Lewis just whacked Fisher. And instead, they just call it out of bounds. It's still late the ball.
Good penetration. Just got to finish that.
Odom. Odom's been shooting well from downtown and does it there. Lamar Odom. A three-pointer, and the Lakers go up by three, their largest lead of the night.
And that's a tough shot by Lamar Odom, but certainly steps in rhythm with tremendous confidence.
7 points for Odom. Austin again to the basket. Flips it up. Tough shot. Won't go. Howard tips it to keep it alive. And a new 24. Redick for three. That's good. J.J. Redick has played big off the bench tonight.
Well, in a lot of ways, J.J. Redick is playing like he played at Duke. He is stepping in rhythm and living with the result.
Ariza inside. Can't get it to go. Here comes Redick. But again, credit Howard's tip for getting that open look. Redick tried to draw the foul. Didn't get it. Ariza running the other way. Goes up and hits the layup. Trevor Ariza, 13 points here in the third quarter.
And that's actually a foul. J.J. Redick, certainly right. The same move that Kobe Bryant makes. Gets the defender in the air. No call, and that's a big play because Trevor Ariza gets a layup on the other end.
You got to run back. You want to win, run back.
Howard inside. Reverse doesn't go. Gets the rebound stolen by Bryant. And then Howard grabs him. Some extra elbow thrown afterwards. Here's where you hope, and they've done it in the finals and the conference finals. They just let these go. These guys just get emotional in the biggest series of the season. The two former USA teammates jawing at each other. Now, earlier in the playoffs, that's probably a technical foul. But Jeff, and I think you probably agree, let that go. That's just guys showing emotion in the biggest game of the season.
Exactly. There's no technical fouls there.
Right.
And I like the fact that both guys a little bit on edge, talking to one another, a little chirpy. We can be friends. We can even win a gold medal together. But this is for all the marbles. Let's have fun and let our head down. You're talking about going after it. Well, Bryant gets after it. Both guys battling. That's great for basketball when you leave it on the floor and compete.
And right there, to me, again, Dwight Howard can't make that foul. That's the bigger issue. You're in the penalty. You're gifting guys shots. You know, the last layup in transition, they gifted them because they didn't run back. They were complaining about a foul call. Right now, when it's heated and it's hotly contested, you've got to remain poised and play through any problems with your officiating.
Ryan, 8 for 8 from the line tonight. He was 5 of 10 the other night. Petrus, nice pass from Howard. Back to a two-point game. Lakers, though, have regained the lead here in a strong third quarter led by Trevor Ariza.
Good job by Dwight Howard being patient and making the right read.
Bryant for three. Gasol, the offensive board. Now it's the Lakers making all the hustle plays. Redick on Ariza. Odom will try another three. And Dwight Howard with his 18th rebound of the game. See, Jameer Nelson has come out for Orlando. Ball's down, taken by Fisher. Fisher knocked away from behind by Lewis, and it's still Laker ball. That turnover, number 16 for Orlando.
A great job by Rashad Lewis, not giving up on the play, chasing down the basketball from Derek Fisher, deflecting it out of bounds. That type of energy and effort is contagious.
Bryant trying to get free. Good ball denial for Petrus. An anti-ref chant here at Emory Arena. There's about a 3-second difference between game clock and shot clock as we finish up the third quarter. Bryant leans in, puts it up, puts it in. Top shot with 4.7 remaining. Here comes Jameer Nelson. Final seconds, does not get it off in time. Couple of tough possessions for Nelson. And the third quarter comes to an end. The Lakers outscore the Magic 30-14 in the third period. And they take a 12-point halftime deficit and turn it into a 4-point lead. Trevor Ariza had 13 points in the period. Kobe Bryant, strong as well. He had 8. And as we head to the fourth, Lakers trying to take a 3-1 lead. This presentation of the NBA Finals on ABC continues after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Gundy, how'd they get back in it, Coach?
Well, I think their defense was great. They were extremely aggressive and physical without fouling at all, and that gave us a lot of trouble.
Trevor Ariza hurt you where?
Well, shooting threes.
Thank you. Coach?
I'll tell you where Trevor Ariza hurt you. He hurt you with his energy and passion. Defensively, comes up with the steal, finishes it in transition. How about dribble penetration? Knocks down the floater, ball movement, all reliable. You move the ball, it's like pool. Three ball, corner pocket. Ariza, 13 big points in the third.
Trevor Ariza, who last year, because of broken foot, missed the last 40 games of the regular season, first 2 rounds of the playoffs, hardly played after that. Didn't like watching, but boy, he's been huge. Nice pass to Odom, and it floats in. Off the inbounds to start the fourth quarter, and the Lakers with their largest lead of the game.
You can see how both coaches understand the moment. Howard stays in, Bryant stays in, Turkoglu back into the ball game.
Turkoglu looking. Tony Battee jump shot. Can't get it to go, and Odom the rebound. And momentum has completely turned here in the second half after a terrific first half for the Magic. Fisher. Gasol double. Fisher's open. Shot clock at 5. lost it out of bounds. Good defense from Nelson. Gasol has to put it up. High arcing shot and an air ball. And a 24-second violation.
If I'm Stan Van Gundy, I would seriously consider, matter of fact, I will put Rafer Alston back into the ballgame. Guy's been playing very good basketball. You're not getting anything right now from Jameer Nelson. It's time to put Alston back in the game.
He is struggling. Had that first good start when he opened in game one, but it's just not himself, and he's admitted that. Shot clock at 8. Pietrus to drive, tough shot, and he draws the foul. Good attacking of the basket for Pietrus, and Gasol is really shaken up on the play. As Pietrus goes to the line, the foul is on Gasol, who's third. It looked like he took a shot in the face. Yep, that right hand of Pietrus comes down and smacks him. Well, last year, as we'll see it once again, Pietrus hits the free throw. Last year, the 2008 finals, Celtics and the Lakers, the turning point was game four. That was the game that the Celtics were down by 24 in the first half, down by 20 midway through the third, came back and won at the Staples Center to take a 3-1 lead. The Lakers trying to do the same, come back. They're only down by 12 to start the third quarter. They're trying to take that commanding lead in this best of seven series.
Well, to me, this game has had everything to do with missed free throws and the turnover differential.
7 missed free throws, 16 turnovers for Orlando. Fisher, shot clock winding down, gets easily to the basket. Fisher. 71-65, Lakers by 6. Turkoglu. Up to Batee. Howard a little frustrated. He was open one of the ball. Shot clock again winding down. Good Laker defense. Turkoglu draws the foul on Odom. That's going to be a 3-point play. Fourth foul on Odom. We've seen that several times tonight. Going for the fake. And Turkoglu goes to the line.
How many times are we going to see guys not be disciplined enough to stay down until the jump shooter leaves the ground? That's a bad play by Lamar Odom.
Yeah, because you're about ready to crack this thing open. You're up 6, you got him wound down in the shot clock. That's a huge momentum swinging play if the Magic can convert the free throw.
Turkoglu hits that. Polls still open for tonight's final player of the game voting, presented by T-Mobile. Text the last name of your choice for player of the game to 69622 from any wireless phone. Voting closes at the end of the game. Turkoglu 6 of 7 from the field, 6 of 7 from the line. 18 points to lead the Magic. And another missed free throw. That's the 8th of the game. Jordan Farmar has checked in for the Lakers. Still plenty of time remaining. Four-point game. Just over 2 minutes gone by here in the fourth. As we said, every loss the Lakers have had in this postseason, they followed it with an impressive win. They have yet to lose back-to-back games in the playoffs. Trying to do it for the 7th time. Bryant knocked away and stolen by Pietrus. Pietrus on the drive. The layup slips, and Farmar has it knocked out of bounds. And it's going to be Laker ball. Pietrus just appeared to slip on the play. And the Lakers will get it back. A missed opportunity there. I don't think there was any contact at all.
No, there's no contact. That's great hustle by Ariza again. Getting back and forcing a missed layup.
Gasol way off the mark. Nelson, offensive foul. Howard wanted the ball, didn't get it, and threw that right arm, and Howard picks up his fourth personal.
And frustrated,
but he does a good job of running down the floor, and then he's open. Right now he's open. Get him the basketball. He's got to be patient. But as a big man, it's awfully frustrating when you're open, not being able to put pressure on the opposing big.
You're absolutely right. And at the same time, he's also got to manage his frustration. Because right now is no time to pick up unnecessary fouls or allow yourself to be frustrated.
A shot quiet won't go. And Gasol, loose ball foul called against the Lakers. It's Lamar Odom. And Odom picks up his fifth, and we'll have a timeout. Just over 3 minutes gone by here in the fourth. Magic trying to tie the series up. They've blown a 12-point lead, trail by four. Their ball when we return. Brought to you by Vizio. Back in Orlando, the series started in L.A. Game one, Kobe Bryant went for 40. And the Lakers won by 25. Game two, though, was different. Magic had their opportunities, couldn't do it in regulation. Pau Gasol, 7 points in the overtime, and the Lakers took a 2-0 lead. But it all changed in Orlando as they shot an NBA Finals record 62.5% to get their first franchise Finals win. Smiles from Dwight Howard. And here in game four, a terrific first half led by 12, but the third quarter it turned around. Lakers defense, Trevor Ariza, Kobe Bryant on offense, and it's now a 4-point Laker lead. Our Verizon Wireless game track showing the difference. 37 points in the first half for the Lakers, but 30 in the third.
And to me right now, with the Lakers going back big, Rashard Lewis has to find a way. Hedo Turkoglu has to find a way to get the ball in the paint.
Lewis, 34 points in game two, 21 in game three, has just 3 points tonight. Howard with Bynum on him. Howard inside, stripped by Farmar, gets it back, stripped by Kobe Bryant. And Bryant took a shot in the face. And another turnover, Dwight Howard, his seventh. They just swarm him when he gets the ball. Gasol to Farmar. Walton will post up Nelson. Nice defensive play, but it goes back to Walton and he puts it in. Nelson poked it away, but it went right to Bynum.
And offensively for the Magic, they're most effective when they're in pick and roll situations. You're not going to take advantage of the Lakers with a steady diet of posting up Dwight Howard in the half court.
Petras, a good open look. Hits a three. Big three from Michael Petras. He's got 11, and it's back to three.
Well, it's just what you said, Mark. Good play by Turkoglu. Simple to Rashard Lewis. Read the rotation by Bryant. Extra pass to Petras.
Walton gets it to Bynum. Bynum playing some fourth quarter minutes.
Only because of Lamar Odom's foul trouble. Oh my goodness.
Kobe Bryant with Petras all over him. And he knocks it down.
And your Petras, you have to contest.
They're going to review that one. They signal to the official score just to make sure he was behind the mark for a three. Gasol comes out on Petras. This time he drives and draws the foul. Good hard drive from Petras. He's had a couple of those tonight. Fearless going to the basket. Let's look at Kobe Bryant's shot, Mark. See if it was a three.
But Petras upset because of fouls being called. Didn't want to contest. You got to put your hands up. You know the rules, Mr. Petras. Hand down, man down.
And that's a two. Clearly a two. And that's what they credit it with. So it's 75-70. Bynum has just picked up his fifth foul. Odom has five fouls. Magic 16 of 24 from the line. Eight misses. Five of them by Howard. Petras is perfect from the line. Five for five.
As good as Howard has been on defense, he's been that inefficient on offense. Free throw shooting, turnovers, just has not been a good night for him offensively.
And a moving screen. This one called against Pau Gasol. That's four on Gasol. Phil Jackson yelling at Gasol. Now he's yelling at Scott Foster.
And if I'm running the point for the Magic, or I'm the head coach of the Magic, I'm saying, Rashawn Lewis, we need you right now. We need you to show up. You're our guy. Show up and show out.
Turkoglu. Lewis, quick, quick pass, and Howard is hammered by Farmar. Lewis saw him right away. And free throws coming up for Howard once again.
Foul number five, Jordan Farmar. His first penalty situation.
Well, good pick and roll. Gasol took the roll man, and that's a good play by Lewis. And Jordan Farmar, I like your courage in there. Putting your face in the play, taking a hard foul. That's how you win in the NBA.
If I'm the Magic, it's exclusive pick and roll the rest of this ball game. That's when they get their best offense, and that's when they get shooters around the perimeter and Dwight Howard ducking in.
And a man who struggled from the free throw line a lot, but has performed much better. He does tend to concentrate. And we've seen him at crunch time of games knock down some big shots from the line as Ariza checks back in. So it's Bryant, Fisher, Ariza, Gasol, and Bynum out there. Howard, Turkoglu, Lewis, Jameer Nelson still in the game, and Michael Petras.
And Howard's got a long time between free throw attempts.
Two perfect free throws there. It's back to two. Just over 6.5 remaining in this pivotal game four.
Phil Jackson putting Fisher and Ariza back in the ball game for shooting purposes to stretch the defense.
Crowd getting on its feet here in Orlando. Bryant rises up. Short. Rebound Turkoglu. Turkoglu looking. Double team off the leg of Bynum, but right to Lewis. Shot clock down to 9. Down to 5. Turkoglu pulls up, jump shot. In and out. That one halfway down as Ariza grabs the board. Just past the midway point of the fourth, a 2-point game here in game four. Gasol drives on Lewis, spins. There's Howard there. Misses, and Howard another rebound, his 19th of the game. Petras goes at Kobe Bryant. He's bumped, puts it in, and a foul. Magic tie the game. With another big play for the Orlando Magic.
Get stops on the defensive end. Outlet pass off to the races. One-on-one. Petras attacks the body of Kobe Bryant. Outstanding job in transition. We have ourselves a ball game.
Ending fourth quarter, game four of the 2009 NBA Finals. Big first half for Orlando. Lakers a strong third quarter. Magic coming back again to tie it at 75. Sunday, we will have game five right back here in Orlando. Coverage begins at 7:30. An earlier start, tip off shortly after 8. And then the series will ship back to LA if necessary for game 6 and 7. Tuesday game 6, Thursday game 7. After a blowout in game 1, the third straight thriller between the Magic and the Lakers, and Michael Petras with a chance for the 3-point play. 14 more points. What a spark he's been off the bench throughout the postseason. Magic back up by 1. Their first lead of the fourth quarter. Bryant. Petras up on him. Bryant the drive to the basket, puts it up, shot won't go, ball tipped out, taken by Odom in a new 24. Odom's pass to Gasol, shot blocked by Howard, but a goaltend. And Lakers back up by a point.
There's no question about that call.
The question is they got to get a long rebound. They did a good job defending.
And yeah, a whistle tough again to hear the whistle right now. Trevor Ariza picks up his second. And the Lakers in the penalty.
And that's a bad play by Trevor Ariza.
Turkoglu running off the screen away from the basket. Your job is to keep a body on him and be in position. Commits the foul. Turkoglu goes to the line.
And here we go again. Free throws. So critical. They've missed 9 tonight. Turkoglu, no arc whatsoever. That was a line drive. He's now 7 of 10. .506 remaining, whereas the Lakers are in the penalty. Magic have not committed a team foul yet. You can see the free throw shooting in the period. 0 for 2.
And he didn't shoot either one well.
And again, no arc whatsoever. Kobe Bryant struggled in the fourth quarter of game 3. Spins, pulls up, shot good. And the Lakers back up by 3. 28 for Kobe Bryant. Turkoglu the playmaker for the Magic. Lewis looking. Shot clock at 7. Jameer Nelson. Inside. Pretty pass and Howard to finish.
That's a great read by Jameer Nelson. Getting into the seams, taking the pressure off of Howard to make a post move, delivers the basketball where he can just catch and fit.
Nelson staying in the game here in the fourth quarter. A beautiful setup that time for his teammate. Bryant again, the drive inside, blocked by Turkoglu. Bryant furious, he thought he was fouled. Turkoglu, Nelson. Nelson again, the drive out to Lewis. Three-pointer, too strong, and Bryant the rebound.
Another good play by Jameer Nelson in transition. Attacking the rim, finding Lewis. Missed a very makeable shot.
Just over 3.5 remaining. 1-point game. Gasol against Howard. Petras leaves him open for Bryant. Misses the 3, and Howard grabs his 20th rebound of the night.
Listen, either you don't double or somebody's got to rotate to the best player on the court.
Turkoglu to the basket. He is hammered. And we'll go back to the line. The foul will be on Ariza, his 3rd.
If I'm the Orlando Magic, you got to talk about that missed assignment. Somebody made a mistake. You cannot allow Kobe Bryant to step in rhythm for an uncontested 3.
He doesn't have many open looks like that, certainly in the playoffs.
I mean, it can't happen. Either I'm doubling and Jameer Nelson understands the situation, or I'm staying at home. But that's something to talk about and make sure that it does not happen again.
I think Bryant probably was like, what's going on here?
And Turkoglu that time. Turkoglu. Head nod there as he finally got it to go. He missed 2 in a row. 20 points to lead the Magic in scoring. 1 of 4 in double figures. Turkoglu misses 3 of his last 4. That's 12 missed free throws for the Orlando Magic. The Lakers have missed 4 tonight. Fisher. On the drive, knocked away by Howard. Nelson inside pass to Howard. Goes strong. Puts it in. And a foul. Chance for a 3-point play. The Magic back up by 2.
And I tell you what, I apologize, Coach Stan Van Gundy. Jameer Nelson is carrying his basketball team without scoring. He's made every play, whether they hit or miss, he is executing and running the point guard position to perfection. Get the deflection on the defensive end, off to the races, the energy by Dwight Howard, Superman getting it done.
Timeout Lakers, a standing ovation here in Orlando. The all-star point guard playing the crunch time minutes as the Magic go back up by 2. Out there, Magic and Jameer Nelson. He has struggled in this postseason since returning after a 4-month layoff from shoulder surgery, but he's made some big plays here, Jeff.
He had, and he had trouble seeing Howard earlier in the game. That time, great penetration and a drop-off. And then here, throws away from the defense. The seal. And the finish by Dwight Howard. Good plays down the stretch. Solid, simple plays by Jameer Nelson.
And again, Nelson had the surgery on his shoulder back in February. As Howard hits the free throw, completes the three-point play. 15 points, 20 rebounds, and a tying of finals record, 8 block shots, shared by several, including Patrick Ewing, the Magic assistant. Bryant. Beatrice one-on-one. He's made him work again. Bryant to drive to the basket, finds Gasol, knocked away by Turkoglu. Ariza, shot clock at 4. Ariza looking, he's got to hoist it up. The three-pointer. Oh, it's good! Trevor Ariza nails the 3 as the shot clock expires.
And that's a big shot, but again, no contest right there as the clock round down. But a big-time shot by Ariza.
16 second-half points for Ariza. We're tied again with 2:20 to play. Turkoglu looking for an opening. Step back, a 3. Bang! Three for Ariza. Magic back up by 3. Under 2 minutes remaining. Can they finish it off and tie the series? Howard the rebound.
And it's still strictly pick and rolls. You're getting great stuff off of it.
Turkoglu steps back. Takes the 3. Now on the drive. The floater's up. It's good. Pino Turkoglu does it again. The Magic up by 5. Timeout LA.
Turkoglu missed some foul shots, but you know the old saying. Pressure either busts pipes or it makes diamonds. In this case, Turkoglu showing off his diamonds, getting it done.
NBA Finals on ABC, brought to you by Coors Light. Introducing the Coors Light 12-ounce cold-activated can. When the mountains turn blue, your beer is as cold as the Rockies. Popeyes, welcome to Louisiana Fast.
What a roller coaster ride. Game 4 here at Amway Arena. Magic were up by 12 at halftime. Lakers storm back, went up by 6 here in the fourth quarter. It's now a 5-point lead. Bryant dribbles it off the foot of Petras. Seven on the shot clock. Bryant the drive, kicks it out, and a blocking foul called on Nelson to try to draw the charge. And they had a foul to give, so the Lakers will take it out of bounds.
Bryant actually was upset because Petras kicked the basketball to send it in the backcourt. Certainly here, looking to get into the seams and make a play. That's the correct call. Not in proper position. That's a blocking foul.
It's their first team foul, but because it's the first one in the last 2 minutes, on the second one, they'll shoot the penalty.
But I like the courage of Jameer Nelson to put his body in front of the ball. Here comes the pin down for Bryant.
He just bellies up on him. Bryant for 3. Too strong. Rebound. Petras knocked away by Olin. Petras gets it back.
Petras is doing an outstanding job of competing on the defensive end against Bryant.
This crowd in a frenzy right now. Under a minute remaining. 5-point Magic lead. Turkoglu looking outside. Lewis leans in for the 2. Short. Rebound taken by Fisher. Lakers looking to push. Bryant spinning in the lane. Back for Gasol. Pretty pass. And it's back to a 3-point game.
And the critical part was Petras jogging back. Didn't bounce the floor. It's a 2-for-1 situation.
So the Lakers do not have to foul. It's about an 8-second difference, maybe a little bit less.
And if you're the Magic, you run it all the way down.
Nelson brings it back out. Orlando by 3. Turkoglu finds Howard. Howard down low. They hammer him. And Howard will shoot free throws. Bryant came over to whack him. With 11.1 second remaining.
I know the crowd upset, but that's a good foul by Kobe Bryant. Your job is to make sure that he doesn't get to the rim, score, and get a 3-point play. That's good playoff basketball, and good execution by the man.
And making sure that he does not get any kind of shot up. He's so strong. He's 5 of 10 from the line tonight.
But how strong is Kobe Bryant that he can pull Superman down?
Good point. Can he make it a two-possession game? Still a three-point lead. He here is getting the rebound. Those along the lane, they can go get the ball on the release of the free throw, but the shooter has to wait till it hits the rim. Lakers still with a couple of timeouts. If they get the rebound, they'll call it immediately. Howard misses both. Timeout LA with 10.4 remaining. So with this three-point lead, different strategy. Will the Lakers try and go for a three-pointer? Did they try and get a quick two? Will the Magic foul? We'll find out when we come back. Goodyear, new Fuel Max tires get you there on less gas. Another finals game going right down to the final seconds. 10.8 remaining. The Magic clinging to a three-point lead. Dan Van Gundy revising the defense. Phil Jackson trying to figure out what his team will do on offense. It's the Laker ball. All right, let's look at the strategy. Mark, how about if you're the Lakers? Do you try and just go for the three and tie, or maybe go for a quick two because you have multiple timeouts?
Well, I'm the Lakers with those timeouts in my hip pocket. I want to get a quick two or a wide open three and then foul immediately.
Jeff, how about with Orlando in terms of fouling to prevent a three-pointer to tie it?
Well, it's very difficult against Kobe Bryant because he can lure you into the foul of a three-point shot. And with the way the Magic are shooting free throws, I'm going to go right to the rim and try to get the quick two.
Yeah, we'll see what the Lakers do. Lakers trying to take a 3-1 lead in this series, and the Magic trying to tie it up.
But taking the ball out full court limits your options about getting the quick two.
Well, there's no question, if I'm Stan Van Gundy and the Magic, I'm fouling as soon as they get in position across half court. If they want to take it out down this far, they're stretching the ball game. I'm looking to foul immediately after they get across half court.
The Lakers have one timeout remaining. That last one leaves them with one. So interesting, they have the option to put it into the front court, but they decide in the back court. Bryant gets the ball in his hand. Back to Ariza. Over to Fisher. Fisher looking. Fisher puts up the three. Ties the game. Derek Fisher ties it with 4.6 remaining.
And what is Jameer Nelson thinking they're going to do? Why wouldn't you be up and crowd the guy? The player's IQ always astounds me of not knowing time, score, and situation.
Or at least at that point, as Fisher's coming up, make the foul there. Meanwhile, Fisher, another clutch three-pointer. He's hit so many in his playoff career.
But I loved how they defended it. What are you doing behind the three-point line? I mean, I'm not understanding what he's thinking about right there.
And Derek Fisher is not a threat. He's doing you a favor, Jameer Nelson, if he puts the ball on the floor and goes by you to the rim. More time being eaten up the clock. This is bad execution by the Magic. Derek Fisher, once again, another big shot for the Lakers.
He was 0 for 5 from three-point range. You see, he's clearly behind the line. That's his first three-pointer. Here's the guy only Michael Jordan and Robert Horry have hit more three-pointers in finals history than Derek Fisher, tonight playing in his 30th finals game.
And maybe you don't feel like you can take the foul because he's faced up to the basket, but what you would do is just get right into him and make him drive it. Just make him drive it.
There's no need to defend under the three-point line when you're up by three in that situation.
Well, that's exactly why I talked about as soon as he crosses half court, taking the foul, so it eliminates you being put in a situation.
All right, but there's still 4.6 remaining. Plenty of time for Orlando, and they still have two timeouts left. All right, what's the strategy here?
Well, to me, again, Rashard Lewis has been very dangerous in these situations. But I'm still going to go, if I can go high-low right into Dwight Howard, that's what I'm going to do, knowing you only need one.
And the good news for Stan Van Gundy, we watch him in these situations. 4.6 is a lot of time to execute out of bounds.
Turkoglu will inbound.
Lamar Odom not guarding the inbound. He's done that, remember, during the Denver series with a couple of key steals forcing out with his big long arms. Ariza is guarding the inbounds here. Turkoglu looking. Has to call time. Now the Magic down to one timeout remaining. Good ball denial from the Lakers. A 20-second timeout.
Actually, the Magic went with a similar play, looking for Rashard Lewis on the baseline for a corner jump shot, or either Dwight Howard ducking in.
So another chance for the Magic to win a regulation. Remember, in game two at the Staples Center in L.A., they had the chance to win the game in a tie game in this terrific play. Turkoglu inbound, lobbed it into Courtney Lee. Just too strong at the buzzer. Howard's dunk too late. And the Lakers wound up winning in overtime. And now Stan Van Gundy drawing up another play. Still has a timeout remaining, and that's critical if they have trouble getting it in again.
Well, one thing I'd like to see in this situation, can't get the ball to Dwight Howard. Turkoglu is a guy that's proven to be able to get his own shot. He's the dangerous, most dangerous guy. He's the one taking it out of bounds. Look for him to get it back.
That happens so often. Your man Reggie Miller, who you played with in Indiana, he used to do that all the time. Inbound, quick get back. 4.6 remaining. Ariza again on the inbounds, not playing up on him, at least right now. Turkoglu looking. Looking. Finds Petras. Petras, 3 seconds to go. Petras puts up the shot of the buzzer. No good. And we're going to overtime for the second time of these finals. Michael Petras rushed the shot a bit, had a little time. As the Lakers on a Derek Fisher three tie it. We've got 5 extra minutes up on the board.
Come on. Come on. Come on.
Petras wanted to get it to Rashard Lewis and couldn't.
Well, again, Turkoglu should have taken another timeout. They had Dwight Howard against Bryant, or kick it out to Rashard Lewis, but I would have taken another timeout if I was Turkoglu.
And that's exactly what Stan Van Gundy pulled Turkoglu aside and said. We talked about it in the timeout. If nothing's there, waste another one.
Derek Fisher, the veteran, with another clutch playoff three-pointer. This one tied the game. Overtime in game four. It's even at 87. Second time in this series, overtime. The finals, Magic and Lakers even at 87. And Derek Fisher knocking down the big three. Here is the final play. Magic had a chance to win it.
Well, they get it into Petras. Right away, Bryant on Dwight Howard. Deliver the basketball. Not able to. Puts it on the floor. Missed touch situation. Rashard Lewis wide open in the corner. Petras not making the play.
He had time to make a quick pass. Howard hasn't sat in the second half. Neither has Kobe Bryant. First time since 1984. Two overtime games in the same finals. 25 years. But after the game one blowout, what a thrilling series this has become. Still out there making some big plays. Turkoglu to Lewis. Shot clock at 7. Turkoglu looking for Lewis. Good defense by the Lakers. Turkoglu to Lewis. Lewis fires away and hits the 3 as the shot clock expires. Just his second field goal of the game.
See the pick and roll. Stan Van Gundy staying with that. Rashard Lewis hits a big
one. Odom trying to post up down low on Lewis. Kobe Bryant the drive. The pull-up puts it in. And it's back to 1.
You see, when you have a guy who can go get his own shot, it's a great luxury. But Magic don't have a guy on the perimeter that can go just take it off the bounce like Bryant and get his own.
Lewis inside to Howard. Howard spins, throws up a wild shot, and Gasol the rebound.
Good entry pass by Rashard Lewis right there. Well executed. Howard off balance.
Seemed to rush it. As Nelson bumps Fisher, they let him play. Bryant's got 30. Kobe Bryant pulls up. It's good again. Back-to-back jumpers, and the Lakers regain the lead.
can't play any better defense. Kobe Bryant is superior on the offensive end.
Beatrice did an excellent job on him once again in the fourth quarter. He had just 4 points in the fourth. Lewis, Howard's open. Turkoglu, pass deflected. Lewis knocked away and taken by Gasol.
And there's no secret where the Lakers are going to go on the offensive end. Bryant brings the ball up the floor.
Under 3 minutes remaining in overtime. Bryant to drive. The floater. Shot won't go. Lewis the rebound.
They got to get something in transition before L.A.'s link sets.
Nelson up top. Turkoglu inside to Howard. Howard puts up the shot. Banker won't go. Ball tipped out right back to Nelson.
I think in those situations, Turkoglu catches the basketball. That's a wide open shot. He's got to be aggressive.
Turkoglu struggles with his dribble. Now kicks it out in the corner. Lewis on the drive. Inside. Banker rolls off the rim. Fight for the rebound. Odom comes away. And not a whistle. Lakers are yelling at something. Coming up on 2 minutes remaining in overtime. Shot clock at five. Bryant looks up on the drive. The pull up, it's a two. Way off the mark. He thought it got deflected. The officials say no. Petras, good defense once again.
He's playing Shane Battier defense. He is staying the course. Bryant making plays. What he's doing is fundamentally sound. Certainly gets a piece of it. Should have been the Lakers basketball.
You think so?
Oh, absolutely. You got to call a foul. He got a piece of it, but certainly off of Petras.
Lewis hands off to Turkoglu. Lobs it into Howard. Howard grabbed by Fisher on the floor. You shoot on the fourth in overtime and the second in the last 2 minutes, so they'll take it out of bounds.
What I love about this, he waits until Bryant jumps and then he extends it. Certainly got the arm of Bryant on the release.
Didn't touch the ball. As Turkoglu will inbound.
But to me, Howard right there is a perfect example. You got to get that shot up.
He's had trouble with that when they swarm him down low. Shot clock at eight for Turkoglu. Odom now on Turkoglu. Turkoglu the drive, puts it up, bank shot, no good. And a whistle and a loose ball foul is going to go against the Lakers. So the Magic will shoot free throws. It's Derek Fisher who picks up his fourth. Watch Fisher come in. A little shove on Howard. Just to push to kind of get him out of the way. Now Howard will go to the line. Howard missed those two critical free throws in the last 10 seconds of regulation.
Well, part of the problem of calling the push foul on Derek Fisher was Dwight Howard doing the same exact thing to Pau Gasol.
And Howard misses another.
Well, if you're going to make this call on Derek Fisher, well, take a look at Pau Gasol as he contests, tries to get back to the body of Dwight Howard, certainly shoves him down. For the Magic, you have to make foul shots.
They've missed 15 free throws, including seven in the fourth quarter, and now one here in overtime. Hits that one to tie the game. Magic trying to tie the series. Crowd's been on its feet since about the 5 minute mark of the fourth quarter. Bryant on the drive, double team. Here comes the double again. Bryant finds the open man. Ariza fakes. Ariza drives. Inside layup. Won't go. Rebound taken by Ariza. Ball deflected out of bounds and still Laker ball with 101 remaining. And Phil Jackson calls timeout. The Lakers and the Magic battling here in the pivotal game four. It's all tied up in overtime. Lakers ball when we come back. Game four, overtime from Orlando. Lakers and Magic tied with 101 remaining. Log on to NBA.com now for the most extensive NBA Finals coverage and in-depth highlights of tonight's matchup, along with up-to-date scores, stats, and schedules from the 2009 Finals. NBA.com. The game happens here. Trevor Ariza, many big plays in this one. The hustle play here after the miss.
Now you give me five Trevor Ariza, and I'll be just fine. The guy wants it more than everybody in a white jersey. Getting after the basketball.
What's so critical right there is you saw so many of the perimeter players, Jameer Nelson, Rashard Lewis, they didn't come back in the paint. You got it. When that ball goes at the basket, you got to get five guys in the paint willing to put their face in front of the ball, just like Fisher's got in rebound situations.
Kobe Bryant with 32. He's just looking. Odom was open. He didn't get it to him. Bryant pounded on the drive. Tough shot. In and out. Won't go. Rebound. Gasol and a loose ball foul against Nelson. They had a foul to give, so the Lakers will inbound again.
I agree with Mark. I didn't like the call against Fisher. I don't like the call against Nelson.
He's trying to box out.
To me, they're in legal position right there, both of them. He might have had, you know what? I take it back. He's got his arm hooked. That's my fault. Scott Foster, good call.
But those are the plays that the Magic have to make when the ball goes up.
Lakers with a lot of big offensive rebounds in the second half. Bryant. Against Peters, here comes the double. Up top to Fisher, straight on three. Puts it in. Derek Fisher with another clutch three. And the Lakers go up 94-91. So many big shots in his playoff career. Tied it at the end of regulation. And a huge one here with 31.3 remaining.
Bryant on the post up, waits patiently. The elbow to the chin of Jameer Nelson knocks him down. That ain't all that gets knocked down. Derek Fisher, long distance, next best thing. Steps in rhythm with confidence, knocks down a dagger three.
Magic ball when we come back. They trail by three here in overtime.
G-Force in your positions. It's showtime.
Get a visual on Sabres wearing a 6,000.
Game 5 will be Sunday back here in Orlando. An earlier start, tip off shortly after 8. Will the Lakers be up 3-1? Or can the Magic come back once again and tie this series at 2? Right now the Lakers in the driver's seat after Derek Fisher nailed another clutch 3.
Oh, this is a big play. Jameer Nelson has a case. He certainly comes down to double. This should be an offensive foul on Kobe Bryant. Swings towards the middle. Elbows Jameer Nelson into the jaw. No question about it. There's nothing else you're looking at. You have to recognize there's a reason that Jameer Nelson hits the deck. Bryant gets away with it, and Fisher gets a wide open look.
All right, for Orlando, Jeff, can you go for the quick two?
Well, I think really you're not going to have time to play quick two or three. You just got to get the best shot you can because they don't have a guy that can just give it to and go by their man.
Lewis looking, just gets it in time. Turkoglu on the drive. Turkoglu for three. Won't go. Lewis tips it out, but Gasol the only one there. And a pass to the basket to throw it down. Lakers go up by 5 with 21.6 remaining. And this crowd stunned, as are the Magic, who call timeout. Turkoglu, a tough shot on the three-pointer. And the carom batted out to Pau Gasol.
And this is the second time that Stan Van Gundy is talking to his team. He said if they couldn't get it in, get a timeout, they do not. They get a tough shot, deflection ahead, and Pau Gasol runs the length of the floor for the uncontested deuce.
Lewis tipped it out for too far, and the Lakers now in command. Magic ball. Huge threes, and the Lakers now up by 5. It's Magic ball, still 21.6 remaining. And they just need to score in a hurry. We see Orlando still with one timeout left, neither with a foul to give. And a two-possession game, so not necessarily a three right away.
If you're the Magic right now, it's about getting a quick hoop.
Turkoglu once again will inbound. looking for Peters, can't get it. Looking for somebody, and just gets it in time to Howard. Very close to the 5-second count.
The veteran coach stuck with his veteran player, and Derek Fisher once again, all reliable, making plays and making shots.
Fisher hit the three-pointer in the final seconds of regulation to tie it, and then hit the huge three-pointer in overtime. So Gasol, a flagrant was called on Petrus. And then the technical on Gasol.
And to me, going forward to game five with 2 days off, the only question the Magic have to think about is, do they still think they can win the series? Because if they don't feel that they can win the series, they'll go meek and mild in game five.
By the way this team has played all season long, that doesn't seem to be an option for them.
Well, they're too well coached, and they're great competitors. They're here for a reason. This team is not going to quit.
And that'll do it. The Lakers come back from 12 down in the second half, force overtime, and take the commanding 3-1 lead. Derek Fisher already with three championship rings, now one win away from his fourth. And the Lakers one win away from the franchise's 15th NBA title. A huge win on the road. And again, throughout the playoffs, they have yet to lose back-to-back games. Seven straight time, they've bounced back from a loss to a very impressive victory. Dwight Howard set an NBA Finals record with 9 blocks, but some missed free throws at the end of regulation really hurt the Orlando Magic. But Fisher, the story with the big buckets, he's with Doris.
Derek, the early part of this playoffs, the storyline was your inability to make shots, yet on the biggest stage, you came through in a big way. How did you deliver?
Faith, confidence, you know, family and friends been praying for me and thinking of me all over back in Little Rock and Waco, Texas, and my teammates and my coaches, most importantly, kept giving me that confidence to continue to believe in myself, and I wanted to come through for the guys.
Let's evaluate that first play that ties it up. Take us through what was happening on the floor as you came down to end regulation.
Well, when you play with number 24, he gets a lot of attention. Yeah. So two or three guys went up to cover him, got it to Trevor. You know, he kicked it up to me. Initially, I was just going to take it over and kind of survey the situation, but Nelson was giving me a lot of space, and I liked to step into those threes, and even though I hadn't been making them, I felt like I could do that, and it felt good to help the team that way.
Mark Jackson talked about Coach Jackson having faith in you. What does that say to you when a coach has that kind of faith through your struggles?
You know, Phil and I have had a wonderful working relationship, and the belief that he's shown in me, you know, to me, he's the best in the business. And for him to have the type of confidence in me, even when it's not going well, he doesn't have to say anything to me at all. We don't have to exchange one word. I know what he means.
Congratulations. Kobe, there were so many plays, big shots made. Derek made a couple. But one guy who continued to give great effort and maybe wanted it more than the rest of everybody else on the floor, Trevor Ariza. Can you evaluate the plays he made that had an impact on this team winning this game?
Well, he just made big plays. You know, he kept the floor space. And he knocked down shots. You know, last game he felt like he had some of those shots and he was really down on himself because he didn't knock them down. And, you know, tonight he knew that if he had those opportunities again, he was going to make the most out of them.
Clearly, it seems like the Magic do not want to let you make plays down the stretch. As you're trying to make those decisions, do I shoot it? Do I give it up to Fish? You know, take us through that process. What is that like? How do you decide?
Well, you know, I felt like, you know, and then late in the ball game, you know, I had the ball too far away from the basket. And it's just, you know, they can double you and do whatever they need to do. You know, what I needed to do is get down on that post, get down on that mid post, and it makes it harder for them to double. You know, they really have to make a choice to come all the way down and get me. And they did, and Fisher's sitting there wide open.
Magic have made you work the last two games, Kobe. How do you close this thing out in the next one?
You know, just rest up the next couple of days and, you know, come back in here on Sunday ready to have a good time.
One step closer. Thanks, Kobe. Thank Mike.
One win away, Doris. As Kobe Bryant is tonight's finals player of the game, presented by T-Mobile. Bryant, the 8 assists once again, 7 rebounds and 32 points, but he had plenty of help, especially from Derek Fisher. Paul Gasol, another double-double. As the Lakers come back from 12 down in the second half. And game 5 could be a clincher for the Lakers. It'll be right back here in Orlando, an earlier tip off shortly after 8, but don't count out the Magic yet. The resilient team We'll love to force the series back to L.A., which would be Game 6 Tuesday, and then, if necessary, Game 7 on Thursday as well. Game 4 was the turning point last year in the finals. It was a Laker loss as Boston won the championship, perhaps this year as well. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Complete postgame coverage tonight's game. Go to ESPN and SportsCenter or ESPN News. Now except on ABC, except for the West Coast. Stay tuned for your late local news, Nightline, and Jimmy Kimmel. For Jeff Van Gundy, Mark Jackson, Doris Burke, and our entire crew, this is Mike Green saying so long from Orlando. We'll see you Sunday night.